Hey friends, welcome back to my channel, Organized with Joy. In today's video, I am out in my storage closet in my garage. This is where we house all of our extra food. You might remember a video that I did on my channel where I did an overhaul on this space and decluttered a ton from the space to make room for an extra pantry out here where we can store back stock. I desperately need to just go through and assess what we have in this space for extra back stock and decide what I can bring in the house, what I need to add to my grocery and Costco list. And I also just kind of want to clean the space in general. But on this side of the storage closet, I'm not going to be doing anything with this side. You might remember a video that I recently had on my channel where I organized my college age son's items to be stored for the summer. All of the items in this corner belong to my son, and they are for his apartment, his campus apartment. So those things will be stored here for the summer. And then actually the boxes that I'm sitting on right now, the top box has our pool toys, which I will be getting out soon, but not in this video. And then the bottom storage box just has extra lids that belong to all the storage bins that I have around my home, or extra storage bins that I have here in the storage closet. But I won't be decluttering or getting or dealing with any of the stuff on this side of the storage closet. In this video, I'm primarily just going to be working on this shelf today. Okay friends, today is Thursday, so that means Thoughtful Thursday for today's video. If you're new around here or just don't know what that means, it just means that I'll be sharing my thoughts on a topic in the voiceover while I share this cleaning and organizing motivation with you. And I'm actually just gonna jump right into it because this is a short video. This project actually did not take me long at all, so I just went ahead and left all of the footage real time because it only took me about 10 minutes to get this done. But let's just jump right into my thoughts for this week. So for today's Thoughtful Thursday video, I wanted to share with you how to stop worrying. As I say that, I realize that that is quite a tall order. It sounds so much more easily said than done. But before I get into that, I thought I would share a little bit of a backstory on my journey with worry and anxiety in my life. I have struggled with anxiety my entire life, or at least as long as I can remember. Even as a young child, I remember being worried or nervous about all sorts of things. As a result of this, I struggled with GI issues and started regularly taking antacids in my teens to combat the symptoms.
I was mostly able to manage my anxiety and GI issues throughout my young adulthood. I did this mostly through trying to control my environment. Keeping my spaces cleaned and organized definitely helped ease my anxiety, and also keeping physical clutter to a minimum helped. However, as I grew older, slowly over time, more and more responsibilities and things piled on me. First, it was getting married and learning to manage not only my things, but my husband's things as well. Then our daughter came along, and two more children after that. The responsibilities and the things kept multiplying. I suppose it was a mercy that I only added to our chaos a little at a time. However, it was like that analogy of a frog in a cool pot of water that began to get hot and boil over time, so that it wasn't noticeable that more responsibilities and stuff were creeping in. By the time our youngest was a toddler, I started struggling with severe anxiety symptoms. I struggled with periodic panic attacks, which began to disrupt my life. My doctor diagnosed me with generalized anxiety disorder and prescribed Xanax, which I could take when the symptoms were unmanageable. I was able to cope like this for several years until my anxiety reached a point where it was affecting my everyday life. The journey that ensued is a whole other story, but ultimately I ended up seeing a holistic doctor and discovering that I had multiple food sensitivities, which were exacerbating my anxiety. I was thankful to have answers, and with diet and supplements, I have been able to manage for over 12 years now. But something else I have learned since then is the power of my thoughts. I have learned the importance of positive self-talk, replacing negative thoughts or negative things I tell myself with positive ones. I also learned about the power of the unconscious mind and started adding sleep meditations and positive affirmations to my daily routines. In addition to this, I have shared before on my channel about how I've been learning about stoicism and implementing these principles in my life. Something that has helped me greatly to deal with my anxiety is the idea of reframing. One of the Stoics, Epictetus, said, "It's not things that upset us, but our judgment about things." When we worry, it is often about something bad happening or about things not going the way we would like them to go. If we can learn to reframe our circumstances, not judging them as good or bad, but accepting them as they are, then our worry dissipates. We must learn that all circumstances in life can be viewed as something that is meant to be for us, for our growth and for our maturity. When we let go of expectations of how things should go, we begin to feel peaceful. Another encouraging quote comes from the Stoic Seneca, and he said, "He who suffers before it is necessary suffers more than is necessary." Understanding that we are not in control of others nor our circumstances releases us from the responsibility to be in charge. Obviously, we are in control of ourselves and everything we do. Every decision we make has a consequence, whether good or bad. Therefore, we have full control of those outcomes. For example, choosing to go to bed at a reasonable time means you will get good sleep and therefore will feel well rested in the morning. However, we cannot control other people, the traffic, the weather, etc. We must let go of that feeling that we can control it in order to experience the peace we long for. In my sleep example, we are in control of when we go to bed and when we get up, but we cannot control if there is a siren or a snoring spouse that wakes us up in the middle of the night. learning to be self-aware of our thoughts and reframing our experiences, and learning to release control of things that we think we have control over but do not, will help tremendously with extinguishing worry from our lives. Like I mentioned at the beginning of this talk, that certainly is easier said than done. Yes, this sort of inner work takes practice, and it is work, so it is not easy, but it is worth it. Well, friends, that is all I have for you for today's video. I do hope that this little storage clean out was motivational for you, and I hope that the talk that I shared for today's Thoughtful Thursday thoughts resonated with you. As always, I love to hear from you down in the comments, so I would love to hear your thoughts on the thoughts that I shared today. But thank you so much for watching this video all the way until the end. I always appreciate those of you who watch until the end, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.